Hello students, and welcome to Maneuver Education. I'm Advocate Nisha Lotia, and today I will speak about the constitutional law, which is one of the topics in your legal aptitude, which will appear for your law entrance exam. Now, in the last year's papers, lots of questions were asked from the constitutional law. So please pay attention. Today I will give you the introduction. The government of India consists of legislative, executive and judicial branches. Now what does this mean? The government of India consists of legislative branches. It means the parliament, the executive who executes the law, and who judicial, like the judges who administers the law, who sees that the proper justice has been done. So the government of India is divided into three branches. The legislative branch is a bicameral parliament. In the sense, it consists of two houses. Bicameral is two houses, comprising of Rajya Sabha, the upper house, and the Lok Sabha. The executive arm, the executive part, consists of Vice President. Who is the Vice President of India right now? Mr. Ramnath Kovind. He's the President of India, sorry. The Vice President, Mr. Venkaiah Naidu. And the Prime Minister, we all know, Mr. Narendra Modi ji. And the Council of Ministers. Now, what does the word Council of Ministers means? Ministers like, for the foreign affairs, ministers like for, human resources, ministers for education. Like, who is for the foreign department? She is Miss Sushma Swaraj. Like for this education minister, who is the education minister? She is Smriti Irani. So, these are the Council of Ministers, and on their advices, the presidents work. Now, see, in a constitutional law, all these points will come. Now, in constitutional law, the main is the preamble. The main is the preamble. Preamble of India. Now, and the constitution. And the constitution. You might have heard this word lots of time, like Narendra Modi ji saying, Samvidhan. Samvidhan of India. Samvidhan of India. Samvidhan is nothing but it is the constitution of India. What are the rights, what are the duties are there, everything is mentioned in the constitution. There are like four parts in it. One of the parts is the directive principles. One is the preamble. Preamble is the base of the constitution. These all points are very important. Preamble of India, Constitution of India. If you buy our online programs, you will come to know about all these points which I have mentioned in my videos, for the online recordings. So, in Constitution law, these all points will, include, and these are very important in your examination point of view. So, government of India is, divided into three parts, like legislative, then executive and judicial. And legislative mein kya aayega? Legislative mein aayega Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha. Executive mein kya aayega? President, Vice President, Prime Minister. Or judicial mein all the judges, all the courts and all the judges, Chief Minister, Chief Justice of India, then High Court, Supreme Court, all those parts. So this is the introduction to the Constitution of India. Now we will see in the constitutional law about the president. The president, as I said, the president right now is Mr. Ramnath Kovind. Here I will let you know the details of president. You have to keep in mind all his details, because it might come you for any form of question. The president of India is the head of the state. He is the head of the states. He acts on the active of the Council of Ministers, and he is bound by such advice. See, the President of India has to, follow the advices given by the Council of Ministers. As I said, the, Minister for Foreign Affairs, Ministers for Education. If before taking any decision, he has to be, heard by, he has to take the advices of Council of Ministers. President ko kuch bhi karne se pehle in log sab ki advice lena bahut hi zaruri hai. Okay, it is one of his duty. All the executive action taken by government of India are taken in his name. See, jo bhi government of India treaties vagere sign karega, jo bhi foreign ministers, foreign affairs mein jo bhi kuch bhi sign karega, wo sab signed, sealed and delivered hota hai. Lekin kiski sign hoti hai? To wo sign hoti hai president ki. So president is one of the head of the state. So he is having so much of power. He will represent India on many other platforms also. He exercises this executive power directly or through officers subordinate to him. He can ask anybody to exercise these powers, subordinate to him. Like he can ask Prime Minister or Vice President or other Council of Ministers to go on his behalf. He can delegate. These are his delegation. Delegate is to distribute work. Delegation power. Okay. मतलब ही वो किसी को भी बोल सकते हैं कि आप जाओ ऐसा करके. So it is a delegation power. The supreme command of the defense forces of union shall be vested in the president. See, this is very important. This has been asked in one paper. The supreme command of the defense is in whose hands? Whether it is in president, vice president. So you have to remember the supreme command of the defense force of the union shall be vested in the president. This has an exclusive power what the president has got. So right now our president is Mr. Ramnath Kovind, and he has all these powers. And Prime Minister, everybody knows right now the Prime Minister is Mr. Narendra Modi. Mr. Narendra Modi. In a parliamentary form of government, the real power rests with Prime Minister and not with the President. See, right now, no doubt, Mr. Ramnath Kovind is a President of India, but you will always hear Narendra Modi's name because actual powers are with the Prime Minister. He occupies commanding position as he is the head of the Council of Ministers. Okay, he is the head of the Council of Ministers. See, this can also be asked in your question and answers, like who is the head of the Council of Ministers? So it is the Prime Minister is the head of the Council of Ministers, and who will take the command of for the defense? That will be the President. Okay, so these types of questions can be asked. Other minister cannot function without Prime Minister. See, all the permission has to be granted by Prime Minister, then only things can move ahead. So other ministers cannot function without Prime Minister. In parliamentary democracy, nation considers him as its leader. Entire nation considers him as its leader, even though he may be the leader of his own party. See, no doubt over here, Narendra Modi is only the leader of his party, Bhajap, but the entire nation considers him his leader. So these types of questions, lots of chances are there to come in your examination. So these points I have mentioned more in my videos. So please check that. So I hope this much is clear to you. Now, for more information, you can visit www.maneuveredu.com, and if you want to join for our online programs, you have to click here. You have to just click here for the online programs, and you can check out the online programs. If any query regarding the course or exams, you can call on any of these numbers, 882-858-1455 or 882-858-1454, your friends who are appearing for the law exams. All the best, and thank you.